Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of Pinky and Rex and the Perfect Pumpkin by James Howe. Narrated by Christina Moore.
Chapter 1. Abby.
They're here! Rex shouted from the front yard. Pinky! Amanda! Your grandparents are here!
Pinky and Amanda burst out of their house, the screen door slamming shut behind them.
Whoa! Their grandfather laughed,
as Amanda wrapped herself around his legs.
At least let me get out of the car, Amanda Panda.
You are out of the car, Grandpa, Amanda cried. And anyway, I thought you would never get here.
Would Grandma and I miss pumpkin picking weekend?
Hi, Grandpa, Pinky called out.
Hi, Pinky. And there's Rex. How's my good as a granddaughter?
Great, Rex answered.
She loved it when Pinky's grandfather called her his good as a granddaughter. Rex was Pinky's across-the-street neighbor and his best friend in the whole world. But as far as Pinky's grandparents were concerned, she was one of the family.
So, Rex, Grandma asked, are you all set to go pumpkin picking?
I've been packed for a week, Rex replied.
Better put your bag in the car then, Grandpa said. As soon as Abby gets here, we'll be on our way.
Abby was Pinky and Amanda's cousin. She lived a couple of hours away and always joined them for pumpkin picking at their grandparents' weekend house at the lake. Rex liked Abby. She and Abby and Pinky were all the same age and enjoyed doing many of the same things. On past pumpkin picking weekends, there had been problems sometimes when Pinky's little sister Amanda had been left out. Rex remembered what her parents had said to her that morning. Try extra hard to include Amanda this year. Rex made a silent promise to herself that she would try.
Are we going to stop at the Red Rooster for lunch? She heard Amanda ask.
Of course, Grandma answered as a car pulled into the driveway. It's part of our tradition, isn't it?
The car came to a stop, and out jumped Abby.
Pinky! Amanda!
Abby shouted as she ran past Rex to hug her cousins.
Hi, Abby!
Rex called out, but Abby didn't seem to hear her.
Abby! Hi!
She called again. Abby didn't even turn her head. Rex's parents had come from their house across the street to join the other grown-ups who were gathering in the yard. Everyone was talking about what a fun weekend the children were going to have. Rex was no longer sure how much fun it was going to be.
Chapter 2. The Perfect Day.
All the way in the car, Grandma and Grandpa kept saying how perfect the day was. The perfect day for looking for the perfect pumpkin. The perfect start of a perfect weekend. Rex gazed out the window at the clear blue sky and the trees with their many colored leaves and thought, I want to go home. Everything felt different. Wrong, somehow. It wasn't Grandma and Grandpa. They were the same as always. They asked Rex how her summer had been and how she liked her new teacher. They even remembered what she would order at the Red Rooster. A hot dog with nothing on it, a large order of French fries, and a vanilla milkshake. No, it wasn't Grandma and Grandpa. It was Abby. And Amanda. And Pinky. The three cousins buzzed and whispered and laughed among themselves. They started practically every sentence with, Remember the time we... Or, Let's do this weekend. Or, Let's do that this weekend. And every time Rex tried to join the conversation, Abby cut her off.
Here it is, Pinky shouted, not long after they had left the Red Rooster.
Meadowbrook Farm, Amanda called out.
Home of the perfect pumpkins, Abby cried.
Rex said not a word.
Do you feel all right, Rex?
Grandma asked softly as they were getting out of the car.
You've been so quiet.
I'm okay, Rex muttered. Grandpa put his hand on her shoulder.
Then what do you say we do some serious pumpkin picking?
Rex smiled.
Okay,
she said. But just as she started to feel better, Grandpa said to his wife,
Isn't it nice to see how well the cousins are getting along this year?
I'll say, Grandma replied.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.